Diwali, and with us we have Miss Aishwarya Pissay, who is the first Indian motorsport athlete to win the FIM Baja Rally World Cup. She's also a six-time national road racing and rally champion. So would you like to tell us about it?
Hi, my name is Aishwarya Pissay, as she introduced me. I'm a motorcycle racer. I race for the factory team TVS. I've been racing for the last 5 years, and that's where both my national titles on rally and road racing is from.
So how did you start your journey as a biker?
I started riding motorcycles at the age of 18, where I started going on weekend trips with my girlfriends. That's how it started. Over a period, I started training for racing because I had a bug for speed. There's a training school called Apex Racing Academy where I started it. And over a period, I started racing and I started doing well. And that's how the factory racing team TVS picked me up.
Oh.
And that became my career, where now I do that for a living.
That's nice. So how did you motivate your girl gang to get into biking? Like, was it difficult or was it their passion too?
They motivated me to get into it. So they are my seniors from college, and their names are Ranjana, Madhuri and Pranita. And I think they used to do it every weekend, and I was not 18 yet to join them. And when I turned 18, I started going out with them.
Oh, you must have faced a lot of hurdles during the journey.
I think there's no journey without any hurdles, and there are hurdles even now as they have been in the past. Probably the initial hurdles were motorsports is a very male-dominated sport, and it's also an expensive sport.
Mm-hmm.
Women coming into the sport and racing with men was pretty unheard of, and moreover, I think since it's expensive, not a lot of women also try to get into it. So initially I would get comments like, it's a man's sport, you should probably just do this as a hobby, and you should probably not take it up seriously. And I think past that was people telling me that I would scar myself if I fell off, and I think that would make a difference, which kind of was least of my problems. And the financial support to be able to participate in national and international rallies was probably one of the biggest hurdles.
And your parents must have been your backbone in this?
So, I come from a family where my parents are separated, so I did have to do a lot of things on my own, and my mom would not do very well off, so I would work and also help her run the house.
That's great.
So, I had to do everything on my own.
So you are a self-made star, I can say. Okay, so who was your inspiration? Like, everybody has their inspiration in motorbikes, so who was yours?
Honestly, when I started, I didn't really have anybody that I could look up to and I could say that this is who I wanted to be like.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I'm that person for a lot more women now. And what I looked out for then was to be the fastest. Didn't matter who it was, because racing is more about skill and not the gender. So I think that's what my inspiration was, to be the fastest.
So you were your own inspiration, that's all I can say. So tell us about your achievements.
So motorcycle racing especially has many forms, and what I per se is my forte is road racing and rally. Road racing is more a man-made track,
mm-hmm.
which is in a certain distance and you go in loops.
Okay.
But a rally is more a natural-made track where it's in the forest, deserts and a lot of areas where there are no people for kilometers together.
Mm-hmm.
So my forte are in the both of these, and I've been racing nationally on the both of these, and internationally now I've moved to just doing rallying because Dakar is one of the rallies that I want to go to. Dakar is the world championship for rally, which is one of the most grueling races, which goes for about 14 days. And every day we ride about 800 kilometers, and that's the race I want to be at.
So that's like your aim or goal, like to be in the Dakar.
Yeah.
So cool. So tell us something, how do you motivate other women out there to come, you know, ride bikes and get into the rallies or races?
For the last couple of years, we have had initiatives where we support women to come race at TVS, where we have a training camps for women, and we also do this selection process for these 1 week championships, which is mostly circuit racing, where we have a selection process, then we have a training process, and there are at least about 15 women on the grid racing against each other. That's one initiative. Then the other one is we do this She Rides at Big Rock, where we teach women not only how to ride a motorcycle, but also how to ride it off-road. So these are two ways that I'm trying to give back and bring more women and encourage them. And I think the other thing that I'd like to say for these women is that if you really want to achieve something, is you need to first invest in yourself, that is training and everything else. And I think if you really want to achieve it, just don't let the naysayers stop you and go achieve your dream. So that's one.
So this is the real motivation, I can say.
But that was probably one of the most smallest accidents. That was the first bone that I've ever broken. But I think the most major accident was last year, mid-season, in Spain, when I was racing my first international event. I ruptured my pancreas and I was hospitalized for about a month. But coming back from that is honestly being a normal human being. I'm a normal human being too, right? So it's kind of emotionally and mentally quite stressful to kind of bounce back. And I think what it taught me was no matter how worse a situation could be,
you need to fight back.
Yeah, you need to fight back and never give up and just focus on what your goals are. And that's what got me out of both the accidents.
Okay, this is really cool. So coming to the end part of it, would you like to tell something to our Rosé members and about Rosé, your experience in Rosé?
Well, you people have created a wonderful space for a lot of women, and in an era where we are in a fast world, I think this gives some time for all the women to get together and share their experiences and also share their experiences.
Relax, pamper themselves. And
yeah, I think it's a good place for all of them to connect.
That's true. Rosé is all about that, to come find your tribe here and, you know, to get the greatest experience and spend your time for yourself. So this is it with Aishwarya Pissay. I am signing off. Thank you.